And now we have a professional MMA contest scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Would you welcome to the cage first, from Leeds, Danny Welsh! And now, would you welcome to the cage his opponent from Fight Ministry in Grimsby, Andy Craven! Introducing to you firstly in the blue corner, wearing blue and white shorts, he weighed in at 66 kilograms, from Leeds, Danny Welsh! And his opponent across the cage in the red corner, wearing black shorts trimmed with red and white, he too tipped the scales at 66 kilograms, from Fight Ministry in Grimsby, Andy Craven! Your referee when the action gets underway is Mr. Craig Lawrence. This is 3 5-minute rounds of professional MMA.
So as our referee brings them together, professional mixed martial arts over 3 5-minute rounds. Andy Craven, Fight Ministry, Danny Welsh, an independent fighter from Leeds. And Jay, I think a lot of this fight depends on what sort of Danny Welsh turns up.
Yeah, Welsh is a well-known guy around the circuit. He fights a lot, but he's a great Thai boxer. And if given the chance, you know, he can do some damage. But as you say, it depends what Welsh turns up on the night and whether he gets that opportunity.
Well, he attempted the knee there as Andy Craven closed the distance very, very quickly to get in this tie-up.
Yeah, Welsh doing a good job there of digging for the underhook. stuffing that takedown on the fence.
Well, with that Thai background as well, the clinch will be second nature to him.
Yeah, obviously a very different type of clinch when you're on the fence in this position. You know, you don't really want to be going for a Thai plum on the cage. You will get taken down, and I've seen Craven fight a few times. He's got big, powerful slams, but so far Welsh doing a good job of negating his wrestling on the fence. But yeah, he goes for that leg and he gets the knee tap. Craven gets on top.
When we looked at these two fighters before and this fight coming up, you felt that would be his tactic, wouldn't it? Knowing Danny Welsh's background, that we would end up here at some stage during the round.
Yeah, Danny Welsh's his record doesn't do his actual amount of skills justice, but being an independent fighter, he could do more to improve himself as a rounded mixed martial artist. And, you know, this is the gap in his game on the ground, and Craven is, you know, he's well within his rights to exploit that.
Yes, Danny Welsh trying to get free there, but Craven having none of it.
Yeah, this is pro debut, Andy Craven. You know, Welsh is a guy who's probably had 50 professional MMA fights. So, you know, he's straight in there, straight in with the Wolves. But, you know, this is a fight that Craven will no doubt be expecting to win, given Welsh's journeyman status. But, you know, on his day, it's not an easy fight for anyone. But there we see Craven get the hooks in, rear naked choke. He's got that short choke, he doesn't have it on the bicep at the moment. He's looking to work it under the chin.
Do feel it's only a matter of time though, Jay, from this position.
Yeah, Welsh is tucking his chin well there. He's looking to try and work out of it. He's not giving it up. He's fighting off the choke there. He's going to make Andy Craven work for this.
But do you feel Craven will be disappointed if he lets this slip and he lets his man back up?
Yeah, definitely. When he's got a dominant position like this, as primarily a grappler himself, it would be disappointing if he didn't manage to get the finish from this position.
Well, his corner there looking at their watches for the timings here, because, as I said, it's a great position, but
he looks to have that choke under the chin there. So, yeah, still plenty of time to work for the choke. It's hard to see from our position, but he seems to be working it under the chin. Welsh back to his feet. He's done a good job of fighting it off there. They say when Danny Welsh turns up and he wants to fight, he can give somebody a tough night, and tonight he's not giving up.
A lot of energy being expended by Andy Craven here, but equally, you know the slam's coming from Welsh, but Craven is still there, and that's the problem for him.
Yeah, he's locked on. He's got a good tight position. His hooks are in, and he's, you know, he's not giving up that back control.
And this is the difference here with the professional ranks. Those five-minute rounds compared to the 3 minutes when you're in a position like this, it's a far longer time to do your work.
Yeah, Welsh trying to potentially turn in from that position, but again, Craven's doing a good job of just following his hips and just maintaining that back control. Yeah, the five-minute rounds give, especially when you get a dominant position so early on, it gives you that confidence that you don't have to rush whatever it is you're trying to do. So, you know, Craven's still got time.
But as you said, Welsh, vastly experienced, and he really has made the effort here to not submit. There's been a couple of occasions when, let's be honest, from the back of the stalls there, you would have forgiven him if he tapped, wouldn't you?
Yeah, definitely, and he's now got top position, so, you know, he's seen it out, he's seen out the threat, and now he's got his chance to maybe inflict a bit of damage.
Well,
nice
big downward elbow, Jay, yes.
His Thai background, he's got heavy elbows if he gets on top, and, you know, he can do some damage when you've grown up throwing elbows and throwing them, you know, in a really heavy fashion. If you can land someone on a position like that, then they're going to do some damage.
A real reversal here for Danny Welsh, who for a lot of the round was defending that submission, that rear naked, but now, as Jay said, looking to land those heavy elbows.
Yeah, and he's got good posture, looking to get the shots off. Craven looked for an up kick there, but almost a pass for Danny Welsh. No, gets put back in the full guard again.
Time!
That's 5 minutes in the bag.
Now, as you said, Jay, pro debut for Andy Craven. Had a lot of that opening round. Really strong rear naked choke attempt, but he didn't pull it off. And Danny Welsh, I felt, gained heart from that.
Yeah, Wells didn't give up at any point, and once he got free, he wasn't trying to coast out the round. You know, he got on top and he tried to do some damage of his own. Maybe Craven was expecting a finish earlier. Maybe he'll be a little bit disheartened, but this is not a you know, a bad thing necessarily to get into the second round in your first professional fight. You want to be tested, and you know, this is a good way for Craven to get that. If he'd have got an early finish, there's not much to learn from it, but he's been taken into the second round, and let's see how it moves on.
And if you're in Danny Welsh's corner, what would you be saying to him now?
He started the round well. He did a good job of stuffing the takedown. Obviously, just, you know, when you're on the ground, try and scramble, try and get on top, because when he's on top, he's got a chance. If he can stay on the feet, he's got a chance. So, you know, definitely don't write yourself out of the fight.
So, Andy Craven coming forward, but the first kick comes from Danny Welsh.
You can tell how relaxed he is with them kicks, and he really turns that hip over. Very good technical Thai boxing. As soon as Craven felt that kick to the body, felt the power, instantly clinches.
Yes, looking to take Danny Welsh down again and gets where he needs to be.
Yeah, got that body lock in and just sucked Welsh's hips in from there. See if Welsh has got anything to offer from his guard. It's not a position we often see him work from. He's switching his hips there, potentially looking for an arm lock, but Craven squares it up, trying to eliminate the threat and, you know, just solidify his position.
He's obviously got the game plan. His corner will have done their work. They'll tell him how dangerous Danny Welsh is upright. And so far, he has done a good job of negating Danny's natural skills, hasn't he?
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, the longer he can stay on top in this position, you know, the longer he's racking up the points and winning rounds. You know, no one would blame Andy Craven for wanting to take Danny Welsh to the ground.
And even now, though, Welsh trying to get those short little elbows in. They're distracting, more than hurtful.
Craven looks for a heel hook. He's sat back, and there's the tap.
Very quick from Craven. Were you expecting that, Jay?
Not at all. He seemed content on top. He's got well under the eye there. He took some damage on the feet, but he changed his tact. He couldn't get through Danny Welsh's guard there. Change of tact, look for the heel hook. And, yeah, Welsh obviously didn't want his knee put out, and a quick tap from him there. Very, very good change of plan there from Craven, and it's worked well. Gets his first professional win.
And he'll have learned so much from it as well, won't he?
Yeah, he hasn't come out of it unscathed. He had a tough first round, you know, good dominant positions. So he'll have learned a lot from this professional bout.
Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, could you please put your hands together for both fighters? The fight came to an end after 1 minute and 29 seconds of round number 2. Your winner by submission victory from Fight Ministry in Grimsby, Andy Craven! Please continue your warm applause for a great opponent from Leeds, Danny Welsh!
I'm here with Andy Craven, the winner of that last fight. Andy, your pro debut, must be pleased, but he made you work for it.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, I'm not all that pleased, really. I wanted to set myself slightly higher standards than that for this fight. I didn't really meet those, so I'm quite disappointed. A win's a win, but at the end of the day, so you've got to ask more of yourself than a win, in my opinion.
Well, we know he's dangerous upright. You did the right thing. You took him down. You had your chances in your first round with the rear naked. Did that play on your mind as you went into the second?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Danny Welsh, I know he's a highly experienced fighter. And he's very durable. Looking at his record, so many of his losses are by rear naked choke. So to attempt it and not be able to get it really played on my mind coming out into the second round.
But when you came out into the second round, Jay Furness was very impressed with the way you changed tack. All of a sudden, you went the opposite way, fooled him, and you got the result. So you were showing that you were always thinking in there.
Yeah, I mean, there's no question about it. This is a thinking man's game. No matter what anybody says, stupid people can't step in the cage and fight. So I had to adapt, but it's still not an adaptation I wanted to be able to make, or sort of not an adaptation I wanted to need to have to make. I wanted plan A to work. I didn't want to have to go to a plan B or C or D.
But the bottom line is, a very experienced opponent, a win, a great pro debut. Well done.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Appreciate that.